Hello everyone and welcome back to Build Fix. This is my monthly series designed to help people choose the best and most sensibly priced components to build a computer with. And I'm going to be changing things up a little bit this episode because for one, we're celebrating the 1 year anniversary of Build Fix. Hooray! Happy birthday, Build Fix, and a huge thank you to PC Part Picker for their continued sponsorship of this series. But secondly, because cobbling together the parts for a gaming PC is a lot harder right now than it should be, and that's for one glaring reason, the GPU prices are too damn high. Today's video is brought to you by the Paul's Hardware Store on paulshardware.net, the only official source for Paul's Hardware merchandise, tantalizing t-shirts, brilliant beer sets, high-quality hoodies, and more, all featuring the classic thumbscrew for tasteful and refined viewers, or the 8-bit thumbscrew for tasteful and refined viewers who hate curves. New designs are added sporadically and at random, so head over to paulshardware.net and get some of that sweet, sweet merch right now. Or not right now, after you watch the video. Either way. So after no fewer than 6 major GPU launches in Q1 2025 alone, you would think there'd be lots of GPUs to buy and lots of enthusiasm for the new options on the market, but instead it's gone completely the other direction, simply because there aren't enough GPUs to meet demand, so all the prices have skyrocketed and there's a lot of scalping going on. Which makes my position somewhat awkward because I've tried to be as vocal as I can about the shortcomings of many of the GPUs that have come out. My advice has been, and still is, to not overpay for the graphics cards that are on the market. Don't pay scalper pricing because that only encourages more scalpers to overcharge for their GPUs. But my channel is also kind of built around recommending gaming PCs for people to build and teaching people how to do that. And I am still gonna be doing that today, but I'm gonna be adding a lot of caveats for people to keep in mind. And as I usually start Build Fix off with a question to the community that's posted about a day before the video goes live, I wanted to attempt to answer the question, is anyone actually building or planning a build amidst all of this chaos that's going on right now? And the answer appears to be that yes, there are a decent amount of people, about 15% according to this poll, who are planning a build or are going to be building soon. There are certainly a lot more people who would like to build right now but are recognizing that the prices are just too high. And I completely agree with this stance, especially if you have a PC that can get you by right now, which appears to be the case for about 50% of you who do have a PC that they're happy with, and about 8% of you should consider not eating poop because it's not the most hygienic thing. This is Build Fix though, so if you guys are looking for parts lists, check the video description down below to jump straight to those. I have an entry level and a high-end option, but I wanted to go over more of the community responses for today because I had a feeling that a lot of people are in the same situation as Void Chi right here. They have a 9800X3D CPU, a nice set of components otherwise with 32 gig RAM kit, a 2 TB SSD, 1000 watt power supply, good choices all around, and a GTX 980 SC from 2014. Because attempting to source something even as sensible as the recently launched 9070 XT is really difficult, and I'm totally with you right here. Don't pay those scalping assholes for them. I'm gonna show you guys how to use PC Part Picker to keep an eye on current GPU pricing so you can maybe scoop one up if it does come in stock. But also thank you Void Chi for watching my content for so long, and I'm really glad that my videos helped you build a system back in 2012. I wanted to see how many people in the responses actually acquired a new graphics card recently, either an RTX 50 series or a Radeon 9070 or 9070 XT. Asmodeus Hacks, for instance, recently got a 9950X 3D that just launched last week, and an ROG Astral RTX 5080. The Astrals are somewhat known for being pretty marked up over MSRP, so Asmodeus didn't share the price here, but it's good to know that some people actually have managed to buy something. AGMM9WN got a 9950X 3D as well, and a 5070 Ti, but again, no mention of the price that was paid. Here's another reply from Platonix5002. This build is very similar to the parts I have listed in the video's description, with a 7600X and a B850 motherboard. An Arctic 360 AIO is probably a little bit overkill for that 7600X, very easily set up for an upgrade to like a 9950X 3D or something like that. The GPU though was a 9070 XT XFX Quicksilver, but they paid $900. That's a cool $300 markup over the base price of the 9070 XT purchased on a restock, which happened the day after launch. I know pricing outside the US is even worse. I still think a $300 markup over MSRP is too much to pay for a 9070 XT though. Next comment is from Zach Owens, who managed to get a 9070 XT on launch day at Micro Center for MSRP, which appears to be far and away the best bet for getting an MSRP 9070 or 9070 XT. Micro Center had a lot of them, so good job Zach by going that route. Rest of the components here pretty solid overall as well. I would say maybe that Geo Geometric Future AIO on the CPU cooler. I've never heard of that brand before. I'm not sure I would trust a brand I'd never heard of before with an AIO in my system, but I'm sure it's fine. I'm sure it'll be fine. But yeah, man, 600 for a 9070 XT, definitely the way to go if you can find one. Next, we have Scott Sturm, who has a 9950X3D build as well with an X870E Godlike. That's a very expensive motherboard. And a 5090 Founders Edition that was $3,800 on eBay. And Scott, I hope you are very happy with your Founders Edition, but I'm using you as an example to tell people, don't do this. Do not buy $4,000 5090s. Because there is a market for $4,000 5090s, scalpers are selling 5090s for $4,000. You see how it goes? If there is no one to buy the $4,000 5090s, scalpers will have to sell them for less money. That's how it works. So Scott, this is in the past. You've got a godlike motherboard. Clearly you have the money to spend, but I'm going to wag my finger just a little bit at you and say, please don't pay $4,000 for 5090s. Oldan3933, on the other hand, has an ASRock Tai Chi 9070 XT, or got a Tai Chi for $730 on launch day. So that's $130 markup over MSRP. And in like a normal, sensible, sane time, I'd be like, that's still a little bit of a mic markup, like $130. Like, what more are you getting for $130 over a $600 version of the 9070 XT? But we're not in normal times, so $730 sounds somewhat reasonable. And they even got it from Newegg, not from Micro Center. And again, solid selection of components. Otherwise, with a 7800X3D, 32 gig memory kit, and a Gigabyte B850 Aorus Elite Wi-Fi 7. Oh, and a thermal take the Tower 600. I like the case, I just recently built in it. Of course, we did see some sad stories as well. Dalton 788, just yesterday, tried to go to Micro Center because apparently they had RTX 5080s restocked. Last person in line that didn't get a 5080. Dalton, I'm sorry, like I'm just showing this to give you a virtual hug. That's gotta be super frustrating. And every time I've seen a picture of people lined up at Micro Center in the past few weeks, that's been my thought, is at some point along that line is the cutoff where they run out of cards. And I feel so bad for the people who are after the cutoff. We'll contrast that with a happier story from Super Retel 7657 though, also with a 7950X3D built and a 9070XT. They got the base model at MSRP, so that is happy as well, although I'm not sure where they bought it or what model it was. Ooh, it's a SFF build too and an N-Case M2. Just a couple more here. Rack Channel was able to upgrade from a 3080 to a 5080 via a Newegg combo deal. Newegg has had some really awful combos that they've paired up with RTX 50 series cards, which seems to be forcing people to buy an undesirable product in order to get the desirable GPU that they actually want. In this case, the rack was able to get an MSI 32-inch 4K 240Hz OLED monitor, and then the 5080 ended up being $1,279, about a $280 markup over MSRP, which, kind of like that 9070 XT that we talked about, is just at the high end where I'd say, like, you probably did the right thing in this case because you have a 5080 now and you didn't pay like $1,500, $2,000 plus for it or something like that. And I'm happy to see that at least someone was able to get a product they actually used with one of those Newegg combos. Finally, we have Dynamite Davies, who got a Sapphire Nitro 9070 XT for an all right price, which I'm guessing means a little bit over MSRP. And that was on launch day, but again, we have a selection of components here that falls very much in line with my entry level build that I have linked in the video's description down below, which is to start off with an AM5 6 core, like a 7600 or a 9600. Then you build yourself a system that has a really nice upgrade path if you wanna switch to something else in the future. And here is that build. It hasn't really changed much since last month, so I'm reusing last month's parts list, where we have a 7600 up on top for $195. That comes with a cooler, so you don't need to add one on. We have a B650 motherboard for $130. It does all the things you need it to do. We have a 32 gig DDR5 6000 memory kit, a 2TB M.2 NVMe SSD, a Fantex XT Pro case, which is only gonna run you about $60, $65, and a power supply with enough wattage to power the GPUs that we might want to install in this system at 750 watts. You might wanna upgrade to 850 watts if you have your sights set on something like an RTX 50. 80 down the line, which recommends an 850 watt power supply at minimum. The point here though is that we're starting off with a base price of $650 for everything except the graphics card. But how do you find a graphics card to add to this build? So if you click my link to this build in the video description, all you have to do is click edit this parts list, and that will add all the parts to the builder tab right here. And this is sort of the build that we have that is ongoing. The parts that you have on this list will be used for the compatibility filter as you search for other components. And the main component we're missing here is a video card. So we'll click choose a video card. So the compatibility filter over here is going to be taking into account stuff like the size of the case that we've chosen to make sure we're not choosing a graphics card that is too large for that case. But if you want to just search for all graphics cards available, you can uncheck that, or you can go to the Builder tab and click Start New. That will clear that, and then you won't have any parts on there that you'll be compatibility-ing to. So from here, we're just going to scroll down on the left side, and we can see the chipset. So this is the actual GPU that we might be looking for. So let's start by looking at RTX 5070s, and we will go ahead and sort by price. I'm going to post links in the video description that will directly take you to the search if you don't want to click the things that I just clicked. And I will also note that PC Part Picker is international. You can go up here in the top right to change your location. Right now we're looking at US prices. And here we can see that of all the RTX 5070s that PC Part Picker has listed, the cheapest one is $713, or about $163 more than the base price should be, which is $550. If we click on that cheapest card, we can see that Asus is attempting to sell it directly for $700. Just a $150 markup for your Prime OC card there, Asus. But Newegg actually does have this card in stock for $700, which is a horrible price, and nobody should buy it. And then the extra $13 is the shipping. Now this is extremely frustrating, because if this card was available for $550, I would give it a buy recommendation right now. It wouldn't be a screamingly good deal, but it would be a solid mid-range card for $550 instead of $700. And while we're at it, I should mention that the Prime model is Asus's base level MSRP card. They do not make any models that are less expensive than this one. So because they have put the OC label on it and probably overclocked it from the manufacturer by like 30 or 40 megahertz, apparently that's enough to justify a $150 increase in price. And we're not talking about scalpers either. This is the price that Asus is selling this card for. So I'll repeat again, don't buy any of these cards for these prices, but you can quickly jump over to PC Part Picker and look at this search in order to see if any of the prices have improved. What you should be able to get for $750 or so is an RTX 5070 Ti. But those are currently starting at $900. What a great time it is to shop for graphics cards in 2025. The only thing possibly slightly more frustrating than those RTX 50 series prices is the savior of PC gaming, AMD, with their RX 9070 prices right now. And these cards currently selling for more than $100 more than a 5070. The 5070 is a much better deal at these prices, even though you shouldn't pay any of these prices. And we'll take a last depressing look at the 9070 XT. Only a slight markup there to $870 for what you'll be paying for that. So obviously this situation is really messed up right now, but my inclination going into making this video before I had reality checked the prices was to say, hey guys, the 9070 and 9070 XT are probably going to be the best bet to keep an eye on to come back into stock and prices to go down in the future. But as of right now, that's obviously not the case. The 9070 and 9070 XT have worse prices than the 5070, even though all of them are horribly priced enough that you shouldn't buy any of them. But what if you're one of the people in those 15% of respondents who is like, Paul, I really need a computer right now, or I've been waiting, you know, I've said I'm gonna wait for the next gen the past three or four generations, and it's time. I gotta bite the bullet and get something. Well, my answer there was going to be this card, but it's now sold out. Okay, well, it's somewhat depressing. I did have a $520 alternative option with the RX 7800 XT. This card was $520, but literally within the hour since I last looked at this, it has now gone out of stock. So we're left with this bleak and depressing outlook on anything last gen that's still a reasonable mid-range card with a 16 gig frame buffer. Okay, this situation really makes my job hard. I had sort of an intermediary option for you guys that was around $500, but that seems to have dried up. So if you need to build a gaming PC right now, and you don't want to pay scalper pricing, and you can't wait, you're screwed. You have no choices. There's just nothing you can do at all. A 7800 XT around $500 would be your best bet, so I guess you'll have to wait for that to maybe come back in stock, if and when it does happen. But even for like low $500 range, I would say I'd much rather have a 9070 non-XT for $550 if that was available at MSRP. So perhaps it is somewhat fitting that the other build I'm recommending today is this stupid thing with an RTX 5090 that's totally overbuilt and is probably gonna cost you $4,000, $5,000, $6,000. This is the high-end build that I posted last week. It's a very nice system all put together. It just comes with that caveat that it has a 5090, which is stupidly overpriced. I'm not recommending people pay that much money right now. That said, this system did turn out really nice. So check out the video if you missed it. If you just wanna like set aside everything else and take a few minutes to just be like, PC hardware is really cool. I'm gonna try to forget about the pricing thing and look at a nice build really quick. And my sincere hope is that future 2025 installments of Build Fix will not have quite the same vibe as this March 1 year anniversary episode. And I'll be able to say, look, here's other GPU alternatives that you can actually buy. For now though, that is all for this episode. So again, links to the stuff that you maybe can buy is down in the video subscription. A big thank you to PC Part Picker for sponsoring this series. And don't forget to check out my store at paulshardware.net if you want to help support my channel by getting yourself some awesome Paul's Hardware merchandise. Thank you once again for watching, and we'll see you all in the next video.